This futuristic looking metal block with the kind of heft to it that feels like you can beat the AI out of Jensen with it is a graphics card. It's an external graphics card, and conceptually, I think this is a really good idea. The fact that you can plug this into a mini PC or a laptop to give it some more graphics card power is awesome. It does have an RX 7600 MXT in it, so it's not the most powerful graphics card, but you should be able to do some solid 1080p gaming with this thing. And Minisforum has also clearly really thought this thing through. Not only is the build quality great, it feels like it was made by an Apple factory worker on orientation day. You know, it's not quite up to the standard of normal Apple products, but it's still very good. I mean, just look at those lovely hex screws holding this thing together. But aside from the build quality, it's also got a bunch of really nice quality of life features. My favorite one by far is the internal power supply. You just plug a Mickey Mouse ear power cable into it and it should fire up. You don't need to carry another wall wart with you. That's amazing, especially considering the size of this thing. I mean, it's smaller than most graphics cards at the moment. Its I/O also makes complete sense. Straight off the bat, they just threw an Oculink port on here, which is amazing. That gives you 4 full-fat PCIe Express lanes to connect this to another system. That's a lot of bandwidth, and it means that it should perform very well. Aside from that, you also get a USB-C port on it, which can apparently deliver up to 65 watts. So this thing has quite a beefy power supply in it, and it splits off into a USB hub. You get 3 extra USB 3 ports from this thing, which again is very useful. Most of the things that you'd plug this into probably doesn't have enough USB ports on it, so I like that addition. And then in terms of video outs, you get 3. An HDMI 2.1 port and 2 DisplayPort 2.0 ports. Now, all of this well thought throughness and build qualityness does come at a very Apple-y cost. This thing costs a lot of money depending on when you buy it. Way too much, in my opinion, considering that this just has an RX 7600 MXT in it. The price in itself is very much a deal breaker for me, but I still wanted to see how this thing performed, because these days you get really powerful mini PCs, and this is a perfect match for that kind of thing. The thing is though, I've had this Minisforum external GPU for the best part of a week now, and I hate this thing. The way that only one of its 2 LEDs light up, staring into my soul, mocking me with the absence of its partner. This thing has been driving me crazy. Getting this thing to work has been a nightmare. Now, I do want to preface this. I'm pretty sure that it's this specific one's issue, and it's not an indictment of this product as a whole, but still, join me for the process of me trying to get this thing to work. And my suffering begins with me trying to connect the MGA1 to this B-Link Sir Mini PC. This little beastie has a real powerful AMD laptop CPU in it, making it a perfect pairing for the MGA1. Except for the fact that it doesn't have an Oculink port, which was kind of part of the reason I wanted to try it. I wanted to see if the MGA1 also worked over its USB-C port, so I hooked them up to see what would happen. Okay, so now we get to see if it works via USB. So the first thing I'm gonna do is flick it on. We have an LED here, other than that, nothing's happened. So let's power the little mini PC on and then see if we get a video out via this. Oh, that's very promising.
2 seconds later.
Never mind. And after several attempts of plugging HDMIs into different holes, it turns out the cable was the problem. Oh, would you look at that? It was the cable that didn't work, which is funny because that's the cable that came with the mini PC. But so the mini PC works. Okay, so I'm gonna shut it down and then I'm gonna try via the external GPU again. So I switched the HDMI cable back to the external GPU, restarted the system, but I still didn't get a signal out. And unfortunately, there were no settings in the Sir's BIOS that looked like they related to external GPU action. Not even Device Manager read the external GPU, and DDU wiping and replacing the drivers didn't change that. Okay, so unsurprisingly, that didn't work. Damn you, not Thunderbolt. Which means now we're gonna have to try something different. Now, unfortunately, I don't have an assembled system. with a native Oculink port. So I'm gonna have to add an Oculink port to this system, which actually, come to think of it, I don't think it's gonna work on this one, because if I remember correctly, I did some testing on this system a while ago, which fried the second M.2 slot on the motherboard, I think. So let's quickly test it out and see if that is actually the case. Now, this should be pretty straightforward. I just plug this into that M.2 slot, hope that the M.2 slot still works, and then we'll have a way to plug our external GPU in. Although there is the problem of there not being a standoff for it. So I'm gonna have to... I'm just gonna kind of weight it down with a box, right? That seems reasonable. There we go. Yeah, I see no problem with this implementation. If it works, it's fine, right? Yeah, I guess that M.2 slot is dead. Okay, let's try a different system. Luckily, this motherboard has a whole bunch of M.2 slots, so we can even alternate between ones if they don't work. Having said that, these M.2 slots also don't have mounting for that short an M.2 card, but it's fine. We can use our box method. It's not a problem. But even plugged into the known working motherboard, the graphics card still wouldn't put out. Wow, I am really struggling to get this thing to give a video signal out. Although this is probably due to BIOS settings, so let's quickly have a look at that. It wasn't. I even swapped out to a new Oculink cable, which didn't help either. Again, the MGA1 didn't even show up in Device Manager, neither did the AMD graphics drivers find it, which left me no choice. So it's come to the worst case scenario, which is having to reassemble this little bastard, which I'm sure you remember from my video last year. This has a native Oculink port on it, but it is such a nightmare to reassemble. I just dropped a bit of it. It is such a nightmare to reassemble that after I did that video, it took me 3 seconds of trying to rage quit on the process. But now, I have no choice. I have to reassemble it so that I can use its Oculink port. Now, to put into perspective just how much of a nightmare this thing is going to be to reassemble, that's what the screw situation looks like. I don't know where any of those go. I disassembled this thing like 6 months ago. Is that even part of it? Is that meant to go somewhere? These are all different heights as well. So I need to figure out... Okay, I'm assuming the taller ones go in the lower holes. And with that genius observation, I started the terrifying process of reassembling this little PC.
Oh, I just got thermal paste all over my hands.
Step one, after cleaning the obvious thermal paste hazard, I attached the GPU board to the bottom of the AIO pump. Step two was to reattach the daughter board that the GPU mounted to. But to do that, I had to figure out its orientation.
So this goes like that. These cables all attach here. Okay, so they do have to go this way.
And then I had to figure out which of the million different types of screws I had to use to mount it.
Okay, it's not these.
Okay, those go in.
That means it's the correct screw, right? This is like reassembling alien technology that you disassembled. Okay, so now we need to plug its crap in. I think I can plug the graphics card in. Yeah.
The next step was to mount the AIO block in place so that I could put the main motherboard on top of it. But then I realized I still needed to mount the standoffs for the motherboard.
That is actually perfect. Although, I need the spot for these feet, which is all of these.
Hey, look at that. We've got all of the standoffs in place and we've remounted the graphics card. This is looking very promising. When placing the motherboard, I was very careful to have all of the cables that needed to come up from underneath hang out over the side so that they could go to the correct place once the motherboard was mounted.
I think I actually have everything where I need it to be.
So now...
Oh!
Are we still good? Yeah, we're still good. So now, I can screw the motherboard down. But I think I need to take the RAM out. Yeah, I need to take the RAM out to mount the cooler.
But I don't know which screws mount the cooler.
But the moment I finished mounting the motherboard, I made a terrible realization.
Oh, there's a connector missing. Oh, bother. Wait. Three, there's also one missing here.
But after removing the motherboard, I couldn't find those cables.
I mean, surely they wouldn't have connectors on the motherboard that aren't in use. That feels like a sadistic thing to do, I don't know. But there's like this cable, but that's a different connector, and it's like it goes into the bowels of the...
So I decided to just ignore the missing connectors, remount the motherboard, and then attach all 8 million connectors.
Would you look at that? I think this is fully assembled. I'm pretty sure it's gonna work now. We do need to ignore the fact that I barely used half the screws. That is a lot of screws left over. And the kind of concerning thing is that most of those screws come from like bits pretty deep in. I didn't know where any of them went. And this is a liquid cooled system. So there's, I don't know, at least a 70% chance that when I turn this on, it's just gonna bukkake liquid all over itself. But yeah, it's a risk I have to take, I guess. So let's plug it in and see if it works. Oh my God, I am very scared. I think this is the power button. Oh, there we go. Okay. It smells a bit weird, but it works! Whoa, I am a super genius. First try even. I guess it's like IKEA, all those extra screws are just spares in case you lose stuff.
With that tangent complete, I reinstalled Windows on the mini PC, plugged the little external graphics card in, and then nothing. The exact same symptoms as before. The graphics card didn't even show up in Device Manager.
You know what? I'm starting to get the distinct impression that I'm not the problem here. I think this graphics card may not work.
The final thing I could think of doing to confirm my suspicion of a dead graphics card was to buy a brand new mini PC with an Oculink port on it. Something Amazon made surprisingly difficult because its filter options feel like herding a cat with ADHD.
So this system also has a native Oculink port on it, and it's brand new, which means I haven't had a chance to break it yet. So if this doesn't read that GPU, then that's the problem.
But after setting up the mini PC and pre-installing the drivers, it still didn't work. At which point, I started to think I misunderstood the product.
Did I misunderstand? Is there no GPU in this container? So at this point, I think all that's left to do is open it up and see if they just forgot to put a graphics card in it. Wow, this is proper metal. Look at it, it's so cool. Here is its power supply, which almost looks like it's from a hi-fi component. Is that a copper heatsink? That's crazy. No wonder this thing's so expensive. It's got like a solid copper heatsink. So that removes the fan. Ooh. Now there was only one brief instance where this fan spun up. When I first plugged USB-C in, this spun up for like 10 seconds, and that was the only time I ever heard it. Now, it was plugged in decently, so that's not the issue. And then under here is a wild bit of cooling. Look at all that copper! Minisforum is known to use liquid metal on stuff, so I don't know if I want to remove the actual cooler. But let's still go deeper and see what's going on here. So this plug is the power, which comes out easily. That's a nice connector, I like that. I know that it's not the power because one of the LEDs fires up. There's even like an inductor with the wire wrapped around it. That's neat. This is amazing. It almost looks like an Apple component. There's so much cooling. I really wanted to see this thing run. I think it's just a DOA component. And then this is the little Oculink board. Again, there is no obvious signs of damage on this thing. Like, it looks brand new and like someone put a lot of effort into making this thing. Now at this point, I was done with this graphics card. I've spent days trying to get it running. It clearly doesn't work. So the next step was to RMA it. So I reached out to Mini's forum on a personal account and they got back to me pretty quickly, asking for a video of how the thing doesn't work. So I reassembled it,
And then, while filming that video, this happened.
Okay, so it's plugged in. It's got power over here. That's the HDMI. The Oculink is going into here. I've also plugged the USB-C in, but that doesn't really affect it. It also doesn't work without it. So if I turn it on, no fans spin up or anything. I don't know if it's supposed to do anything. And then there's one LED on here. And then when I turn the mini PC on, what? Oh my God, it's working. What? So this is after I took it apart and reassembled it. So I assume that there was like a daughter board or something not seated properly. I fixed it! And not only does that solidify my status as a genius, but we also get to see it running. So I installed some drivers on it and tried some gaming.
Oh, it's finally running. Look at that. We've got 100% utilization on our 7600 MXT. And with Cyberpunk at 1080p high settings, we're getting 82-ish frames. Oh, it dipped quite a lot there. In the 80s, depending on what's going on. Very nice. The temperatures are also good considering the form factor. I mean, it makes sense. There's a lot of copper in this thing. It is quite noisy though, although I'm not sure if it's the mini PC that's being noisy or the external graphics card, but something is whining pretty hard here. But I don't care. I am just very, very excited about my genius that fixed it. And with my ego handily inflated, it brings me to the end of the video. Thank you very much for watching. If you enjoyed the video, subscribe to the channel. Maybe watch another one, a suggestion will pop up in a second. And until the next video, bye-bye.